Hello friends, welcome to TechStudySell. In this video, we will make a IoT project using the Arduino and NodeMCU to control the appliances with Alexa, IR remote and also from the manual switches. And you can also monitor the room temperature, and if there is no internet, still you can control all the appliances with IR remote and manual switches. For this project, you don't need any Echo device. And I have used all the free tools, so everything is free. And as you can see, you can make the circuit without using any PCB. So this is a very useful project that you can easily make for your home. Now before going to the details, let me show you how this project works. Alexa, turn on switch 1.
Okay.
Alexa, turn off switch 1.
Okay.
And I can also use this IR remote to control the appliances, as you can see, and I can use this button to turn off all the lamps together. Now let me use the manual switches, and you can see again I can easily control all the switches, and you can also control these appliances from the Amazon Alexa app. Let me go to device, and if I tap on the first button, the first lamp will automatically turn off. And I have also used EEPROM memory of Arduino Uno. Let me turn off the supply. So as you can see, I have turned off the complete supply. Now when the power comes back, it will remember the previous state and the lamps will automatically turn on according to the previous state. So this is a very useful project, and I will highly recommend you to watch the complete video, as during the video I have shared the circuit, code and all other required details. So after watching the video, you can easily make this project. So without any further delay, let's get started. These are the components for this project, and for the IR control, I have used a 188 IR receiver with a metallic case. And you can use any IR remote, and for manual control you can either use latch switches or push button. Now we have to connect all these components as per this circuit diagram. In the circuit, I have given the 5V supply to Arduino NodeMCU and the relay module, and the IR receiver and DST11 sensor are connected with the Arduino. And if you want to use switches instead of the push button, then you have to refer this circuit. You just have to connect the switches across the GPIO pins and the ground pin. So the circuit is very simple. You can easily make it without using any PCB, but still I will always recommend you to make the circuit on zero PCB or any custom designed PCB to avoid any loose connection. So I have already made a PCB for this project to make the circuit compact. You can download the Gerber file from the video description and order it from the JLC PCB. In JLC PCB, you can also use their PCB assembly service absolutely free. You just have to pay for the components. To use their PCB assembly service, you have to generate three files. You have to generate the PCB Gerber file, then BOM file, and at last beacon place file. Then visit the JLC PCB. You can find the link in the description. Then you have to upload the Gerber file. After that, I will scroll down. Now I want all the components should be soldered on the top side of the PCB. Now I have to upload the BOM file and pick and place file. So here you have to confirm all the components that you want to use for the SMT service. So you can see they are showing approx footprint, and you will get all the details here. After checking all this, click on save to card and place the order. And in my case, I have received this PCB from JLC PCB within a week, and as you can see, the packing is really good and also the quality is very premium in this affordable price. Now after soldering all the components, the PCB will be look like this. Now here, instead of the Arduino Uno, I have used Atmega 328P microcontroller. And I can easily program this microcontroller with this FTDI232 USB to serial interface board. And at this place, we'll connect the NodeMCU, but we'll connect it after programming this microcontroller. And now let me connect the DST11 sensor and the IR receiver with the PCB. Now before programming these two microcontrollers, we have to configure the Arduino IoT cloud.
So if you don't have any account, you can create new one I have already an account, so let me log in. After login, first I have to create a thing, so let me click on create thing. After that I will add a device with this thing, so I will click here, and here I will click setup new device, and here I will use NodeMCU, so I will click on this, and here I will select ESP8266, and here I have to select a model which is NodeMCU 1.0. then I will click on continue, then I have to give a name, then click on next. Now whenever you add a device, you will find a device ID and secret key. So let me copy the device ID and secret key in a notepad. This will be required in code. Now I will check this box and click on continue. Then click on done. Now we will add variable to these things. Before that, let me give a name to these things. Now I will click on add variable. Then here you have to give the name for that variable. I am giving switch one. Then I will select Alexa compatible, and here I will select switch. Then variable permission will be read write, and variable update policy will be on change. Now click on add variable. So our first variable is created. In a similar way, I will create another three variable to control total four relay. In the fifth variable, I will monitor the temperature. So let me click on add, and here I will enter the name temperature. Variable type will be Alexa compatible, and here I will select temperature sensor with degree Celsius, and the variable update policy will be periodically, and here I will select 8 seconds. So after every 8 seconds, it will update the value in the dashboard. Now click on add variable. So our things is ready. Now we will quickly define the dashboard. So let me click on dashboard. Then I will click on build dashboard. First let me give a name to this dashboard. Then I will click on add button and select the switch. Now for the first switch visit, I will give the name switch one, and then I will link the variable. So this is our things name, and I am linking switch one variable with this switch visit. Now I will click on done. In a similar way, I will add another three switches and link the variable with those switch visit. So here you can see I have added total four switch visit. Now I will added a gauge visit to monitor the temperature reading. So let me select the gauge, and here I will enter the name temperature, and I will link the temperature variable with this gauge visit. And here you can also set the minimum and maximum temperature value. Let me set the maximum temperature 70 degrees Celsius. Now I will click on done. So our dashboard is ready. Now let me click on these things. Now if I go to sketch tab, you will find a sketch is written automatically when you created all these variables. But for this project, just to make the things simple, I will not use this automatically generated sketch. Instead of that, I will use this sketch, and you can download it from our website iotcircuithub.com. Just visit the article link given in the description, then you can download all the codes from these buttons. Now let me open the code for the NodeMCU. First you have to install the ESP8266 board, and for this sketch you need this Arduino IoT Cloud library. So when you try to install the Arduino IoT Cloud library, then you may get this pop-up to install all the dependency. So please click install all to all the dependency for the Arduino IoT Cloud library. After that, I will enter the device ID here. So let me go to the notepad where we have saved the device ID. Let me copy it. Then I will paste it here. Then I will enter the Wi-Fi name and the Wi-Fi password. Now I have to enter the device key or secret key. So again, I will go to notepad, and here we have saved the secret key while we have added the device. Now let me paste it here. Now in my previous project, you have seen I have entered the things ID, but they are now not providing the things ID. It will generate automatically. So I have commented this line. Now if you go through the code, you can easily understand how the code works. And here you can see the switch 1, switch 2. These are the variables we have created in the things. So here you can see in the things, we have created this switch 1 variable. So if you give any different name to your variable, then you have to change this variable name accordingly in the sketch. After doing all these changes, just connect the NodeMCU with the laptop, then go to tools, then select the board as NodeMCU 1.0 and the proper port, then hit the upload button.
Now for programming the Atmega 328P microcontroller, I will use this FTDI232 USB to serial interface board. Now let me connect it with my laptop.
Now let me open the main sketch for the Arduino Uno. This is the code for the buttons. In this sketch, you can see first you have to install all these libraries. I have also mentioned the version and related GitHub link. Now here you have to update the hex code of the iRemote buttons. Now let me upload this code to Atmega328P or Arduino Uno. So in the board I will select Arduino Uno, then port is COM3 in my case, then hit the upload button.
After programming the microcontroller, let me remove it, and we have also uploaded the code to this NodeMCU. Let me connect it. Now I will configure the Amazon Alexa app for this project. First, let me open the Amazon Alexa app, then I will tap on more and select skill and games. Here I will search for Arduino, then I will tap on this, then tap on enable to use. Now it may ask to log in to our Arduino IoT Cloud account. It is showing Arduino skill is linked, so I will close it. Now I will tap on discover devices. It may take some time, and as you can see, this blue LED is glowing, which indicates now the NodeMCU is connected with the Arduino IoT Cloud. Now as you can see, it is showing 5 devices discovered. So if I go to switches, you can see these are the device variable we have created. Here we can also monitor the room temperature. So here you can see the temperature variable which you have created in Arduino IoT Cloud. So this is our room temperature measured by this DH11 sensor. So now let me control the appliances with Alexa. Our project is ready, and I have already given the supply to the PCB. Now let me try to control it with Alexa. Alexa, turn on switch 1.
Okay.
And you can see the lamp turns on, and I can also control it with the push button and also from the IR remote. So this is a very useful project you can easily make. So if you like this video, then please give a thumbs up and share it with your friends, and I will really appreciate if you support our work on Patreon. You can find the link in the description, and don't forget to subscribe for more such videos. Thank you for watching. Have a great day.